If you want to chart your data, in other words, take a database here, or in this case a table, and be able to put it in chart form like a column chart, a bar chart, donut chart, they do have those, you know. Just go ahead and click anywhere within your database or table, come up here and click on the Insert tab, go to the Charts group, and there you go. You've got pie, you've got your scatter lines. Let's do something simple. Click on the Insert column, and you've got 2D. When you hover over it, you get a preview down below, and then you got 3D. Ooh, that's pretty cool. Let's keep it simple. Go back to 2D, click on it, and there you go. Let me hover over it. You can see I've got a four-way arrow. When you see that, that means it's in move mode. I can then click and drag it and put it to the right-hand side of the table that the chart is based upon, the data therein. And you can see down below in the legend that the books are in blue, the MP3s are in red, and let's see if it jives here. For January, there's January, the books are $600. So there you go, books are in blue. It goes all the way up to 600. Now for MP3s, it goes just a little past 800. If you just hover over that bar there, it gives you the exact value, 825, and it checks out, 825. Now, new to 2013 are these buttons over to the right-hand side of every chart that you insert, and they are the chart elements, the formatting, and the filtering, which basically is in replacement of the layout tab. If you notice up here, we don't have a layout tab that was available in earlier versions of Excel. That's been replaced by these three buttons down below, which not only contains elements from the layout tab in earlier versions, but other parts that you see up here on the tab, like the chart styles. We'll go over that in just a second. But first of all, let's go over the chart elements. Click on the plus sign. You can see chart elements. And the elements of the chart, like the axis, if you click on it, well, it removes the axes, both the Y and the X. In other words, if you recall your algebra days, there's the Y-axis, there's the X-axis, the horizontal and the vertical. And in fact, when you hover over it, you get that little triangle. If you click on it, you get more options to choose from the primary horizontal, the X or the vertical. If you don't want the horizontal, then remove the check. But then I can't tell what months these sales were made in, so I better go ahead and add it, okay? You also get more options, which brings up the task pane here to format for the axis if you want to go ahead and format it. And you can see in the chart that it's selected, we've got this line that goes around it with these little handles to show that it's been selected. And then we can come over here and choose axis type, vertical axis crosses, axis position on tick marks, between tick marks, and then you got your tick marks. You got additional things that you can choose from as far as, well, you can see the tick marks right there. You can do outside. What if we did inside? Then it goes on the inside of the chart instead of outside it. You may have to zoom in or go ahead and try it on your computer exercise here for creating charts. Let me go ahead and go back to outside. So it's on the outside that comes inside the axis here. And then we also got the option for labels and numbers. Do you want label positions next to the axis or do you want them high? So there we go. There goes the labels right on the top. Ooh, that looks awful. Let me go ahead and undo. So you get a lot more options over here in the task pane. Let's go ahead and keep it simple. But if you want to get nitty gritty, it's all over here. I can go ahead and close out. Then click on chart elements again. What about something more simplistic like grid lines? When you hover over it, you get an arrow you can click on to expand it. And you can hover over to get a preview, like for primary, major, vertical. If you look in the chart, you can see it's going vertical. When I move off of it, it's no longer vertical. You get more options. Again, it brings up the task pane. So you have three layers there. Let me go ahead and close out. When you click on the chart elements, you have your first simplistic. If you're like, no, I don't want any axes altogether, you can go ahead and turn it down and say, well, I do want one, but not the other. Or I do like them, but I want to go ahead and get more detailed about it. So you can go ahead and pop open the task pane, make your changes. Let's go ahead and close out. Let's go to the next one, which is the chart styles and the colors. So you can see here in the pop-up, it's the same thing that you can see up on the design tab. At least this way, when you click on it, you don't have to go too far and to click on the design tab and then go to the chart styles. If your mouse is way down here, I mean, because that's a lot of work to get all the way up here. Whew, I'm worn out. Go ahead and look at one of the, hover over it to get a preview. And there you go, puts the value right on top of the columns there. I like that one. That one's fancy. I'm going to choose that one. And then if you like the style but you want to change the color, then come up here and click on color. Or you can come up here and click on the change colors drop down arrow. That works. And then notice with the colors that you've got the themes here. The first product, which is books, is in blue. The next one's in red. If I go down to the next one, then the first product is still blue. the second product is now green. So there's the color for the second. That would be the third if we add a third one, and so on. Man, that looks kind of cool. I'm just impressed with myself here. Click on that one because I like it. And you can scroll down to get other options as well. Now, these are theme colors, so when you hover over this and you get the pop-up that says, hey, how do I change these colors? Well, if you want to customize your theme colors, then you can watch my training video on that, but it's on the Page Layout tab. Go to the Themes group, and I've got a separate video dedicated to your themes and the colors and the fonts and the effects. So you want to watch that if you want to mess around with these colors here. Otherwise, what you see is what you get. Go ahead and select one, and when you're done, well, you can click off. Go ahead and select the chart again to bring up the three icons, and then you've got the filter option. Click on that. And if you don't want to see MP3s here, and you just want to look at the books in the chart, go ahead and uncheck it, and then come down here and click apply, so it can actually apply the change that we made, and there you go. Now we're just looking at books. So it doesn't delete it, just hides it. If I want it back, go ahead and check it, then click apply, and we're back to where we started. Now, if you want to switch the data around, let me go ahead and click off. Click on the chart again so we can close that window. Let me come up here on the Design tab, go to the Data group, and you can switch it and have the row convert to the column data and the column data to the row data. Click on it, and there you go, we flip it. So instead of having the months here, we now have the books, and we can look at the books by month. For January, we were doing pretty good, then our sales dropped in. Well, you can hover over it. April, that's not too good. Then we went up, and then we dropped down again. So it looks like April and June, we just don't do too well for books. And there's a bit of consistency, at least with the MP3s, so it must be the time of year when nobody cares about reading or listening to music. In any case, we can go ahead and switch that back. And let me go ahead and resize the chart. If the chart is too small, too big, you don't like the size of it, you can hover over any one of these resizing handles until you can see arrows pointing in opposite directions. Then go ahead and click and drag it, move it around, and there you go. Let's go ahead and create a couple more charts here by coming over here and clicking anywhere within the table for sales and fantasy, going to insert, and this one, let's do a simple line chart. Come up here, click on the drop down arrow. We've got 2D line, select it. That's not too bad. We don't have to worry about columns now. We can just see how it dips and moves around and go, ooh, July was horrifying. And let's go ahead and find an area that I can see a four-way arrow. You want to be careful where you move your mouse. You can see how I got a four-way arrow. If I click and drag that, it moves the inside part of the chart or the chart window. Let me go ahead and undo that. If you want to do that, that's fine. Let me go to the outside here and click and drag so I can move the chart and move it down and hover over one of the corners to resize it by clicking and dragging in so it fits. Oh, getting anal here. All right, looks good. Let's go ahead and scroll down. Now, those two charts that I created were based upon tables. Let's go ahead and create one that's based upon a data range. It's not a table. And when I click on a cell inside the data range, you can see it's not a table because it doesn't have the related contextual design tab that says data tools here, like it does up here for design. Okay, let's come down here, click in there, and let's come up, click on the insert tab, go to the chart group, and let's do it for pie. And the reason why I want to do it for this one is because it doesn't have that much data, so I can easily spot the pie slices because I've got a slice for human resources, IT staff, you know, five slices, as opposed to something else that, well, for all the months here, that's 12 slices. So the slices look pretty thin, and it's hard to gauge how I'm doing with sales if I can't really analyze each pie slice because I got too many slices. So I'll leave that in column and line charts. And for my smaller databases, let's use pie. You can use whatever you want, but my recommendation is if you're going to use pie at all, use it on a smaller database with just a few labels. So come up here, click on pie. You also get donut. Ooh, that's fun. Let's see, 3D. That's all right. Let's go ahead and click on that, and there we go. Click and drag and move that down, and then we can go ahead and resize it just a bit. And you can see each slice, human resources, is, ooh, that's kind of tiny. It's the light blue. Of course, you can hover over the slice, and it says human resources, and it gives us the value. And I'll show you how you can modify and customize your charts in the next training video and additional training videos to help you work with them in case if you don't want to have to hover over each one of these slices or a part of the chart like the column chart to get the value. We can actually have the labels displayed and customize it that way rather than going with the default style that has them. Like if I come up here, chart styles, of course you can go ahead and click on the paintbrush for the style that when I hover over it, convert it into percentage. That's always fun. Let's see what this one looks like. Okay, it actually moves the labels inside. What if I want the values inside? Do we find one? And I don't see one here. It looks like it's just all percentages. So if you don't want to go with one of the style templates here, or you do, and you say, okay, I want to go with this, but I want to tweak it, we'll do that in the next couple of training videos. Thanks for watching. Hey, as a quick reminder, if you like my video, please give it a thumbs up. You can also click on me and subscribe to my channel, get notified of the latest videos, and for only $2 a month, you can have access to all my Microsoft Office training videos.